Very good morning to all of you. This is Kritika Paliwal welcoming you all in the grammar class again, English grammar class again. So in the previous lecture we had started chapter number 4 of English grammar, okay, and that is subject and predicate. And in the previous lecture I had told you that today we are going to solve the exercise that is given on page number 18 of your Pansy book. So till then we are doing the revision again. You open this page number, okay? So we are going to recall we had studied in the previous lecture. Okay, so chapter number 4, subject and predicate. Let's discuss about subject and predicate one more time. Okay dear, subject and predicate, what are these two? These two are the parts of sentences. Sentence ke ye do parts hain, subject and predicate. Okay, so what is the subject? Subject is the naming part of a sentence. What is the subject? It is the naming part. And what is the naming part? Naming part kya hota hai? Naming part is the part whom we are talking about in the sentence. Naming part sentence ka wo part hai jiske baare mein सेंटेंस में बात की जा रही है. आई होप आई एम गेटिंग क्लियर टू यू. ओके, सो द नेमिंग पार्ट इज कॉल्ड द सब्जेक्ट. नाउ कमिंग ऑन टू द प्रेडिकेट पार्ट. व्हाट इज द प्रेडिकेट पार्ट? इट इज द डूइंग पार्ट ऑफ अ सेंटेंस. ओके, सो डूइंग पार्ट, व्हाट इज डूइंग पार्ट? नाउ नेमिंग पार्ट इज द वन जिसके, दैट मीन्स जिसके बारे में हम सेंटेंस में बात कर रहे हैं. अब क्या बात कर रहे हैं वो हमें बताता है डूइंग पार्ट. ओके, डूइंग पार्ट टेल्स अस दैट व्हाट द सब्जेक्ट इज डूइंग. ओके, डूइंग पार्ट टेल्स अस व्हाट द सब्जेक्ट इज डूइंग इन द सेंटेंस. ओके बेटा, सो नाउ लेट्स प्रोसीड द रिविजन विद एन एग्जांपल दैट आई एम गिविंग टू यू. फॉर एग्जांपल, डोरेमोन इज अ रोबोट. Now in the cartoon they tell us that Doraemon is a 22nd century robot. We are not going to talk about it. We are talking about this sentence. Doraemon is a robot. Okay? So now here, can you tell me in the sentence ki about whom we are talking? What is the subject here? Can you tell me? Yes, you can tell me. And I know most of you told me from there only ki ma'am Doraemon is the subject. So you are absolutely right. What is the subject here? Doraemon. What is Doraemon? It is our subject in the sentence. Now what is the predicate? The remaining part. जो part बच गया subject को छोड़कर वो हो गया हमारा predicate. Okay? The remaining part is the predicate. Okay? The remaining part is the predicate. Why it is the predicate? Because this part is telling it us what is the subject. ये पार्ट हमें सब्जेक्ट के बारे में बता रहा है. इफ आई विल राइट दिस डोरेमोन हियर, अगर मैं सिर्फ डोरेमोन लिखती तो आपको कुछ नहीं पता चलता कि व्हाट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. डोरेमोन तो है बट क्या? ओके, अनलेस एंड अंटिल आई हैड रिटन दिस, नाउ इट इज क्लियर टू यू ना कि डोरेमोन इज अ रोबोट. ओके, सो दिस पार्ट इज टेलिंग अस दैट व्हाट द सब्जेक्ट इज और व्हाट द सब्जेक्ट इज डूइंग. Okay, so Doraemon is a robot is the predicate part in the sentence and Doraemon is the subject. Okay, it is clear now. Now we are going to solve the exercise and with that exercise subjects and predicates will become more clear to you. So just open page number 18 of your Pansy book. Sharp your pencils, hold your eraser in your left hand or the right and just start writing with me. Okay? Just a moment children, till then you start, open the page. So beta, a very very nice exercise is given there on page number 18. I want you to open this page, page number 18 of your Pansy book. Okay, so let's start it. Page number 18, exercise number A. Okay, exercise number A of page 18. I am writing it here also so that you will not get any doubt. So exercise number A, now I am reading the question for you. Okay, the question is, divide the following sentences into subjects and predicates in the table given below. Okay, I'm explaining it in Hindi so that you will get a more clear idea about what we have to do in the question. In the question, we have to divide the sentences. हमें sentence को divide करना है two parts में obviously because sentence has two parts, subject part and the predicate part. तो हमें इस table में, in this table, we have to write the subject part. हमें यहाँ subject part लिखना है sentence का and here we have to write the predicate part. यहाँ हमें लिखना है predicate part. Okay, so all the 10 sentences that are given to us, the writing area is given here in this table. So you have to write all the answers there. Now, let me make a table for you here. Just as it is there in the book. Okay, so here we are going to write all the subject parts. Here we will write all the subject part of the sentence. And here the predicate parts. So children, the first sentence is, sentences, I shall not be at home tomorrow. Can you see the sentence given here? First sentence, I shall not be at home tomorrow. Okay, so here we have to divide the sentence in two parts. So can you tell me what is the subject here? I shall not be at home tomorrow. The subject will be I. Okay, the subject will be I and the remaining part will be the predicate. The predicate is shall not be at home tomorrow. And a full stop. Okay, beta, don't forget to put a full stop there. So, the subject in the sentence is I and the predicate in the sentence is shall not be at home tomorrow. Okay, moving on to the next sentence. Sentence number 2. Sentence number 2, I'm reading it for you. Kavita is my elder sister. So, who is the elder sister? Kavita. So, what will be our subject in the sentence? Kavita will be our subject. So, I am writing Kavita in the subject column. K capital because it is a name. K-A-V-I-T-A. Kavita. And the remaining part, that is the doing part. Okay? That we will write in the predicate column. Kavita is my elder sister. Okay, beta, just write it fast. Then number three is, third sentence is, birds fly high in the sky. Birds fly high in the sky. So, who fly high in the sky? Birds fly high in the sky. So, what will be our subject? Birds. Okay, so I am writing birds in the subject column and the remaining part will be there in the predicate column. I hope you all are understanding. Okay, so birds. What will come here? Birds. B-I-R-D-S. Birds fly high in the sky. The remaining part will be the predicate part. Okay, the remaining part is the predicate part of sentence. So birds, the remaining part starts from fly high in the sky. Okay, then number 4. Sentence number 4. I hope you all are writing it in this area. The area given, na? The table area. You have to write the answers there. Numbering is also given there. So, the fourth sentence is, My parents have gone to Shimla. Mere parents Shimla gaye hain. So, who have gone to Shimla? My parents. So, my and parents, both the words will be our subject. Not only a single word my, okay? Sirf my subject nahi hoga, my parents. Both the words will be our subject. Because, kiske parents gaye hain, kaun gaye hain? So, my parents have gone to Shimla. Okay? So, my parents, both the words will be the subject. Okay? So, I'm writing it here. My parents. M capital and P of the parent need not to be in the capital. Okay, my parents. Then the remaining part we will write in the predicate column. Okay, so the remaining part is have gone to Shimla. Okay. Remaining part is have gone to Shimla. And Shimla, the S will be capital. Full stop at the end. Okay. Why the S will be capital here? Because Shimla is a proper noun. Shimla is a city aur ye city ka naam hai. So that's why Shimla, the S, the starting letter of the word will be capital. Okay. Then moving on to the fifth question. I'm reading the sentence for you. A giraffe has a very long neck. Giraffe ki jo neck hoti hai, jo gardan hoti hai, wo bahut long hoti hai. Hoti hai nahi? Right? So, a giraffe has a very long neck. Now, who has a very long neck? Kiske bare mein baat ho rahi hai sentence mein? About the giraffe we are talking. So, a giraffe will be our subject. Okay. So, we will write a giraffe in the subject column and the remaining, the rest of the things in the predicate column. A giraffe. A giraffe. A giraffe, okay, and the remaining things in the predicate column has a very long neck, has a very long neck, okay, and a full stop at that. So, write it fast, I'm giving you time to write. सब्जेक्ट पहचानना है, वी जस्ट हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द सब्जेक्ट एंड द रिमेनिंग थिंग्स विल बी द प्रेडिकेट. ओके, एंड आइडेंटिफाइंग द सब्जेक्ट इज नॉट एट ऑल डिफिकल्ट, राइट? सो जस्ट डू इट फर्स्ट, देन आई विल गिव यू सम होमवर्क. सो द सेंटेंस नंबर 6 इज द गर्ल्स आर सिंगिंग एंड डांसिंग. द गर्ल्स आर सिंगिंग एंड डांसिंग. So, who are singing and dancing? The girls are singing and dancing. So, what will be our subject? The girls will be our subject. Okay? So, just let write the girls in the subject column. T capital because this is the first letter of our sentence. The girls, G-I-R-L-S. The girls. Now, the remaining things will be covered in the predicate part. The girls are singing and dancing. Okay, the girls are singing and dancing. So the girls will be our subject here. And what will be the predicate of the sentence? are singing and dancing. These group of words will form the predicate of the sentence. Okay? So just write it fast. Okay, now if you are writing slow, you can take the screenshot. Just take the screenshot first, then I am going to rub the screen. Achha, just notice one thing. See, lines are given like this in your book also. See how have I written? देखो मैंने कैसे लिखा है? I have touched every single letter to the line. Every letter is touching the line ना? सारे letters जो हैं वो मेरे line को touch कर रहे हैं. क्या मेरा कोई letter ऐसे हवा में उड़ रहा है? No. So you know when I see your notebook, some children write like the letters are flying high in the notebook. Okay? They are not at the line. They are not on the line. So better for the good handwriting, you have to write all the letters touching the line. Okay? So in that way your handwriting will look even more good. Okay? Now what you are going to do is, see 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th sentences remaining. These sentences are remaining, right? So you will do all this in the homework. Okay, beta? What will be your homework? The 7th sentence, the 8th sentence, the 9th sentence and the 10th sentence of the same thing, subject and predicate. Here is this the 7, 8, 9, 10. From Archana is an intelligent girl to the sun shines brightly. All these sentences are your homework to do. Okay, just write down homework there. Then we will do question number B. Okay, 7, 8, 9, 10. These sentences are your homework for today. Okay, beta, done na? Now, the last question of the exercise. Question number B. See, that's a very, very interesting question. In this question, what is given? See, I am reading the question for you. Question number B of the same page, page number 18. Okay, question number B. So, what does question number B want us to do? Look at the pictures and form sentences. Now, pictures are given there, na? Picture number A is given, picture number B is given. We have to look at the pictures. Hame pictures ko dekhkar sentences banane hai. We have to form sentences. Okay. Use the pictures from box number A to form subjects. Box number A mein jo pictures hain, we have to use them as subjects. Okay. Box number A mein jo picture hain, hume unhe subjects ke jaise use karna hai. And similarly, box number B pictures, we have to use them as predicates. Okay. So box number A we have to use it as subjects, box number B we have to use it as predicates. Now see, an example is done for you. Number A, an elephant. Now you can see na, an elephant given in picture number A. See, an elephant is there in picture number A. Picture number A mein ek elephant diya hai. Theek hai? An elephant. So humne likh diya an elephant as a subject. Matlab book ne likh diya hai. Okay? So in picture number B, the trunk is given. Elephant ki jo trunk hoti hai, the sound, okay? That is given in picture number B. So, we have to make predicate part from that. So, an elephant has a trunk. They have made this sentence. An elephant has a trunk. Okay, sentence number A is, an elephant has a trunk. Okay. So what is the subject here? An elephant is the subject. Okay, and has a trunk is the predicate part. Then number B, what can you see? See, just behind the elephant. Elephant ki just peeche dekho. What is that? It is a monkey. A monkey is given there. So just let write the monkey as a subject. A monkey. Okay. Now in picture box number B, what can we see that is relating with the monkey? हमें क्या दिख रहा है जो monkey से relate कर रहा है? अच्छा, can you see a long tail here? See, there it is given, a long tail. So does a monkey has a long tail? Monkey की एक long tail होती है? Yes. So we will write that as a predicate. So we will write here, a monkey has a long tail. Okay. And a full stop is must. Don't forget to put the full stop. Okay. Then number C is, what can you see there? So many animals are given na? A kangaroo, a tiger, a giraffe, right? Okay. So a tiger. Okay, we are talking about the tiger. So here a tiger is there. Ek hi tiger hai na, isliye we will write a tiger. A tiger. Now what does the tiger have? See, tiger ka jo baki bacha body part hai, matlab uska jo body hai, that is given on column number B, picture box number B. So what can you see there? Can you see its body? Its body has stripes on it. क्या आपको दिख रहा है उसका बॉडी एंड स्ट्राइप्स ऑन इट? स्ट्राइप्स क्या होते हैं? ये ऐसे ऐसे जो स्ट्राइप्स बने होते हैं ना बॉडी पर, ब्लैक लॉन्ग स्ट्राइप्स ऑन द बॉडी, दीज आर कॉल्ड स्ट्राइप्स. आई होप इट इज विजिबल. लेट मी गिव अ चेक. हाँ, इट इज विजिबल. ओके, सो दीज आर कॉल्ड स्ट्राइप्स, दीज ब्लैक लॉन्ग लाइन्स ना. सो अ टाइगर हैज स्ट्राइप्स ऑन इट्स बॉडी. यस, इट हैज. So let's write it here. A tiger has stripes on its body. Okay dear, just write fast. I'm giving you some time to write. अपर बॉडी ऑफ अ कैंगरू. मुझे कैंगरू जो होता है ना, आपको पता है, डू यू नो व्हाट इज अ कैंगरू? द वन हु हैज अ पाउच इन इट्स बॉडी टू कैरी इट्स बेबी. वेयर टू ड्रॉ? ओके, सो अ कैंगरू आई कैन सी इन पिक्चर नंबर ए. सो इन पिक्चर नंबर सी, फाइंड द अदर बॉडी पार्ट ऑफ द कैंगरू. व्हाट कैन यू सी? सी हियर, अ पाउच इज गिवन इन व्हिच अ कैंगरू इज देयर. एक पाउच दिख रहा है आपको, वो एक कैंगरू की बॉडी पे होता है, ऑन द स्टमक. उस वो पाउच ऐसे होता है, एक एरिया होता है जिसमें कैंगरू अपने बेबी को रखता है. सो कैन यू सी अ बेबी कैंगरू देयर इन द पाउच, जो ऐसे झांक रहा है बस? ओके, सो बेटा वी विल कंप्लीट द सेंटेंस विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट बेबी कैंगरू. कैंगरू हैज अ, व्हाट इज दैट? कैंगरू हैज व्हाट? इट हैज अ पाउच टू कैरी इट्स बेबी. सो वी विल राइट अ कैंगरू, KANGARO. कैंगरू हैज अ पाउच, POUCH. ओके, अ कैंगरू हैज अ पाउच. देन सेंटेंस नंबर ई, व्हाट एल्स कैन यू सी? कैन यू सी अ जिराफ? ओके, एंड द अदर साइड ऑल्सो देर इज अ जिराफ गिवन. सो व्हाट डज द पिक्चर शो अस? व्हाट स्पेशल थिंग डज अ जिराफ हैज? जिराफ के पास क्या एक स्पेशल थिंग होती है? Giraffe has a very long neck. Yes. So a giraffe has a long neck. That's why, you know, giraffe ka jo face hai wo picture number A and B. दोनों जगह दिया. ओके सो अ जिराफ हैज अ लॉन्ग नेक. लेट्स राइट द सेम सेंटेंस हियर. अ जिराफ हैज अ लॉन्ग नेक. अ जिराफ हैज अ लॉन्ग नेक. जस्ट राइट फास्ट. ओके एंड टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट. नाउ कैन यू सी देयर आर सिक्स एनिमल्स गिवन. There are six types of animals given in the picture. There are six types of animals given in the picture, but you are given the space of only five to write. आपको सिर्फ five sentences का space दिया है. One more line, draw a line with the help of a scale, and then write the another sentence. Because the camel is remaining. Okay, the camel is remaining. So number E. Write down sentence number F. Okay, draw a line with the help of a ruler. Ruler की help से इस तरह से आप line draw करेंगे. Then we will write about camel. We will write a sentence about camel. So what does a camel have? Camel have. See, if this is a camel, don't laugh. Okay, this is a camel. So what a special thing does it have on its body? It has a hump like this. Okay, he has a hump like this, na? Sorry, it has a hump like this. So this portion, is it there in the other box? This is called a hump. Okay, what is it called? It is called a hump. So we will write about the same. See, a hump is given there. So a camel has. A hump on its body. Or just write this only. A camel has a hump. Okay. So here your chapter 4 is finished. Don't forget to do the homework. Just take a screenshot of this, and then on this note we will finish the lecture. So what had you studied in today's lecture? What have you studied in this chapter? We had studied that a sentence is made up of two parts. First part is the subject part, other part is the predicate part. Subject part is the naming part, and predicate part is the doing part. Okay, so here for example an elephant has a trunk. So what is the subject here? An elephant is the subject, and what is the predicate? Has a trunk is the predicate. So just do it fast and send it to me. Send your homework to me. I'll better check that. And on this note, we will finish our today's lecture. Study hard at your home. Take care of yourself. Okay. And till then, we'll meet in the next lecture with another new chapter. So bye bye. See you.